Hi everyone, this is Patty. I'm here today with a guest spot feature for Tammy Merrill at Country Craft Creations. And if you watched my video just a few back, you saw the package that Tammy sent me with all of these. One of the paper lines was called Blush. Let me turn this around here so you can see. Blush. And these are pretty cut up because this is what I've made for today's project. I took the blush paper line and I took this Tim Holtz assemblage clock, and I'm going to insert a photo here of what it was like when I started. Now you can see what it looked like at the beginning, and I took a combination of gesso and Martha Stewart's paint. This is called Wedding Cake. It's kind of a cross between a very pale cream and a white. And after I covered the whole clock with gesso, then I painted it several coats with that wedding cake. And then I took a combination of Glimmer Mist, Tattered Angels Glimmer Mist, and Dazzling Diamonds. And I started with this Plumeria Glaze, also from Tattered Angels. And I put those together in a mister bottle and I sprayed it, but it just wasn't dark enough. So I added some of this Valentine Pink Glimmer Mist to it, also Tattered Angels. I added it to it and sprayed it again, and you get this just this very soft pink color. And that's what I wanted. I fussy cut from the paper a strip. It's this one and this one together, and I cut it in half and decoupaged it on the sides of the clock. I had taken the glass out and I wasn't planning on using it, so I put everything back together and painted the whole inside when I thought, gee, I think I kind of want the glass. So I glued it in, back in with some Beacon 3-in-1 glue, because I had already taken it all apart, and it comes with these little hingy things that are supposed to hook on the screws on the inside. Well, I had it together and painted before I decided I wanted the glass in. But the glass is in there good and tight, so if you're going to glue anything, this is a great product to use. The flowers here on both sides are actually, they're like this, is what I've used. This is an old spray. Years ago when we had Roberts here, it was a Utah big craft store. Well, they went out of business a few years ago and they were selling everything at 90% off. So I picked up this long spray. It was probably 15 feet long, you know, like a swag. And I cut all the good stuff off and threw the rest away. And I put these in a Ziploc bag. And I've pulled them out over and over again. And I used those same sprays that I used on this to color these little bits here, and I glued them down with the Fabri-Tac, and I put some coming out from underneath the bell on this side. I created a flower here, and this is using the Heartfelt Creations Ariana Blooms. I didn't use the stamps, I just used the die cuts on this one, and then I inked them with ground espresso, scrunched them all up, sprayed them with water, scrunched them all up, and let it dry because it's really stiff now. And I went back and added a little bit more of the ground espresso around the edge to get that agey look of the rest of it, the vintage look. On the little angel here, I took and added some stickles in gold, and then the diamond stickles on her head. And that completes, oh, I took heart. Tammy had sent me this beautiful lace, but it wasn't working for this project, but it will work for others. But I took one heart and took the center heart part, and I put it right here on the top, fussy cut a bird, I did back the bird and the little angel here on brown cardstock so that when you saw it from the back, you didn't have a printed pattern on it, and it makes it sturdier that way. Okay, let me show you the back of the clock. This is the back, and I have one of these. Let me turn it around here. This is handmade, and I just used some of the paint on it and let it dry to give it that vintagey look. This is another one of the hearts with a butterfly and a heart cut from the paper, and that completes the back. I cut around out of the paper to cover this, and this is metal. So what you have on the inside when you open it up is you have a mini album. And because I put magnets in the back, the last page of the mini, it magnetizes to the inside of this back cover so that you're not going to be losing your mini on the inside as it goes around. Now I'm going to insert a picture here so that you can see what I started with. The outsides are a little bit bigger. They are two placemats we picked up at someplace in our travels. The inside are a set of coasters that I've had for eons and worked just great. Okay, you can see from the picture how I did this, and then I painted all of the round edges. I used this dye from Tattered Lace. This is an Essentials dye, and I found the circles that were closest to this one and cut them out with the dye out of the color, out of the decorative paper, and then I painted around the outside edge. I punched a hole on both sides, and then I tied them alternating. Well, you'll see. When I turn it this way, it's tied on this one. The next one is tied on the next one, and so forth, so that you get a real accordion mini here. I didn't put any other decorations on the inside because when you get photos on here, this is going to make it bulky enough, or memorabilia, or journaling, or whatever you want. But there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. There are 10 placemats here. One of them still isn't right. Let me see. There we go. 10 placemats here. Or, 10 coasters here that have been covered. So that gives you 20 spots. And this is a pretty good, you know, you could have a 4-inch square photo and cut it in the round, and you'd have 20 photos here. Okay, now, I don't know why that's, there we go. Not wanting, there. I don't have them right, is what it is. This is the hardest part of showing you, because there, now it's right. Now, because I put magnets underneath here, and I put two of the big magnets, and this is metal, I want to find my top, which is that one, and it's going to go this way, and then I'm going to attach it. And then I just lay my clock over the top, bring my bow to the inside, and go down, and there we have the mini in the clock. I just love how this turned out. I think it's just darling. I really appreciate Tammy letting me play with these gorgeous papers of hers. I hope you'll try a project like this. Lots and lots of fun. And this was real out of my element, guys. I've had this clock for a long time, but I don't alter as many things with the paints and whatever, so this was kind of stepping out for me, and I have to tell you, I really, really enjoyed it. So thanks for joining me. Be sure and check out Tammy's store, Country Craft Creations. I will put a link to the store below, and on my blog post, I will link to all of the products that I used from her store. Thank you very much for joining me. Have a great crafty day. If you haven't subscribed, I hope you subscribe, like, and comment today. Bye, everyone.